Hello everyone, myself Adarsh. Welcome to this tutorial. Today I am going to tell you how to create the Athenio table attribute and how to export the data from Athenio table attribute into CSV file. So with the help of the Athenio table attribute extension, you can create table attribute for products. If you want to store multiple data in a single attribute, then you can use the table attribute module. Table attribute allows multi-dimensional presentation of product data in the form of a table. Here you can check the detailed description of the module. You can also check the FAQ related to this module. You can also check the live demo, like how the working of this module and user guide. So for the installation of the module, you have to follow the user guide. Now I'm going to click on the user guide. So the user guide will look like this, and here you can follow the installation of the module, and you can also check here how to create the attribute and how to add this attribute into the products and how to export from Athenio to CSV files in the user guide also. After installation of the module, you have to visit to your Athenio dashboard. So basically your Athenio dashboard will be looking like this. For creating the table attribute, you have to click on the setting. Here get the all attribute list, and for creating table attribute, you have to click on the create attribute. After installing the module, you can see the table attribute here. So for creating a new table attribute, you have to click on the table. Here you can see the some settings, like you have to enter code and attribute group. You can also export the data to multiple locales, so you have to enable these options, and you have to also enter the label translations. So I'm going to enter the code first. Here you have to choose the attribute group. You have to create a separate attribute group, or you can use the existing one. So I am using the existing one I have created already. So click on this. Here you have to enter the translations. So after it, you have to click on the save button. After click on the save button, here you will get the option columns. Here you can enter the column code, translation, if you want to export the data in multiple locales, column type like text, select image, files, validation. Validation basically checks whether you are entering the wrong data or right data. Configuration, you can do the configuration for the simple and multiple select attributes. So now I am going to enter the code, like name. I am going to create a column, so I am choosing the type text for the name, and I'm choosing the validation, not blanks. So it checks whether the name field is empty or not empty. Now I'm going to perform action. I want to use this column, so click on the right icon. Here you can add another column, so I'm using another column for the color attribute. Basically, I am doing here the reference select attribute. Here you can select the validation, so I am choosing not blank, and here you can select the reference attribute, so I am going to select color and click on the save icon. Here I am going to add another column like size. Here I am entering text and here I am entering select type and validation. I am going to use validation like not blank. Here you have to enter the value and label, so click on the add an option. So I am entering value cap small and label white and medium. And last one, large. Now click on the save icon. So now I'm going to use another column like for images and files. So here I can select the type image and validation like I want to use JPG type of images, and here I can save it. I am going to add another column like file. Here I am selecting file and select validation. Here you can select zip, PDF and doc. So I am using zip. Click on the save button. Here I am adding another column for date. Here you can select the type date and validation like not blank and click on the save icon. Here you can, after adding the columns, you can click on the save button. You can see all your columns. To use this attribute in a product, you have to add this attribute in a family. So I am going to click on the family. Here I have already created some family and I am going to do with the test table and here I have to enter the attributes. So here you can enter the attribute like I have created table demo. So click on the add, click on the save icon. After it you have to create a product with this attribute, so you have to click on the product icon. Here you have to click on the create button and click on the product. Here you can enter the SKU of the product like engine test table. You have to choose the family like I had already created test table. So click on the save button. You can see the test table product and you can see the table attribute here. Here you will get the option to add a row. So you can see here you can enter the column name like insert color. So you have to choose the color. I am choosing yellow. Size, I am choosing medium. Here you can select the image. You have to browse for the images. So I am using this image and you have to also browse for the files. Here you can select the date. of creation of this product. So I'm going to click on the 26th April 2019. You can also add a new row. After entering this data, you have to click on the save button. You can also assign the category to this product. So I'm going to assign to its close 11. After it, you have to click on the save button. If you want to export this product from a Kenyo to CSV files, you have to create a new export profile. You have to click on the create export profile. Here you have to enter. So show I'm entering. Product export. Here you can select the export job. So product export in CSV. I am selecting here, and after it, you have to click on the save button. You can see the export profile. You can also reset it, and if you want to export with header, you can click on this to enable this. And if you want to export files and images, you can enable this option. So I am enabling both. Here you have to choose the delimiter. So I am choosing comma separated. You can also select the content. So here I am selecting the channel, e-commerce, attributes, all attributes, family, test table. Here I am selecting the categories as I assign the product. So after doing these things, you have to click on the save button. Here you can click on the export now button to export. Here you can see the export profile executing. So you can see the export profile is completed. So you can generate the CSV file. For it, you have to click on the download generated files. Here you can click on the OK button. You can see the product as you have created, exported to CSV files, and here you can see the all the product data like demo, size, cert, and you can see the table demo attribute and all the details here. So thanks for watching this tutorial. If you have any query regarding this module, you can raise a ticket at support@webbeko.com.